going to create a simple shower cubicle in BricsCAD. To begin, I'm going to use the box tool. I'm going to apply a fillet. Offset the edges and extrude down. Next, I'm going to draw a guideline along this top surface from the corner to the curved edge. Notice that when I hit the shift key, the surface turns blue. This means the user coordinate system is aligned to that surface. The next step is to draw a circle. I've used the guideline as a snapping point, and then extrude down. Now, taper this surface. I'm using the endpoints of the guideline as the direction for the taper and setting the angle to 1. To make it a bit more visually pleasing, fill it to the edges. And a slightly larger radius to the front part. I'm now going to make the foot grips. Again, I'm hitting Shift to align the user coordinate system to the surface of the shower tray. First, I'm drawing a line out from the center of the plug hole at 90 degrees. And now I'm creating a circle. I'm going to use this as a trimming line. Over here, I'm going to draw a simple cylinder and apply a fillet to the edges. With the align command, I'm going to move the center end points to the end points of the line that we just created. To repeat this, I'm going to use an array polar with a snapping point to the center of the plug hole. The fill angle will be 90 degrees, and the items, 5. Now that I'm happy with how the surface is looking, I'm going to apply some walls. First, I want to measure the distance out. I don't know what the length is now that I've chamfered, but what I can do is use BricsCAD snapping points and then move along to create something in line. Notice that when I repeat the action on this side, a red line appears, which allows me to keep the box in line with the end point. Using the box tool again, I'm going to create the wall, snapping to the lines that we just created. I'm going to repeat the action on this side, but you can also mirror along the guideline that we created earlier. The next stage is to offset this curved line here. I'm going to snap to the end point of the wall. And now use the sweep command to sweep the face of the wall along this curved line. I'm now going to divide the door in two using the slice command. And change the transparency to 70%. This is looking quite good, but without a handle, I'll never get the door open. They're using a cylinder, fillet, offset, extrude, and union. I can create a simple handle. Now all I have to do is move it into position. Going to use the edge of the door as the mirror line for the handle. Notice that the handles don't quite meet the glass. I'm going to use Tconnect, select the surfaces, and extrude to the curved door. As a final touch, chamfer the vertices. That concludes this tutorial. Thank you for watching.